Hey, it's Greg from Scholar Farms, and we are doing a holiday unboxing of the new Micasense Altum just arrived. And so I'm gonna go ahead and unbox it, tell you a little bit about what comes in the box if you end up buying the Micasense Altum. So first you get the Altum itself here in this hard case with some packaging on it. We'll set that aside. You get the M200 GPS mast along with some accessories, and this is really to mount the light sensor. So you have to mount it, in this case, on the M200, and that's what we're going to be flying in for the spring for capturing a lot of data. You also have the integration kit here with lots of components and parts in it, and this is for integrating into both the M200 and the M100. So in the M200, we're going to put the sensor directly on the gimbal bay, which is a new feature of the Altum. On an M100, you would just mount it directly underneath, and they have brackets and things that you can just screw it on. Then we have the all-important calibration panel, and so you still need to calibrate your imagery. If we open this panel, you can see a nice white reflectance panel on there, and you would set this down, and then you hold the drone over, and then you take a picture, and you do that before you fly, and that way, as you fly time series data and you want to look at change in vegetation, you really need those lighting conditions or the amount of light bouncing off the plants to be the same. So you have to calibrate it with something like a reflectance panel, and that way you can really dial in and compare apples to apples over time. So that's the importance of the panel. We've talked a lot about it in some of the vlogs. Okay, let's go ahead and look at our sensor here. We'll open the packaging. Nice hard case and pop it open. And here you can see, I'll just kind of open that up. You have the sensor, you have the DLS, downwelling light sensor 2. And then you have a quick start guide here just to get you started on the components. So let's look at the sensor itself. We'll pull it out and you can see it's a nice red. It matches my hat actually. It's very festive. And it has a nice lens cover. This is a rubberized cover here covering the lenses. And so here we have red, green, blue, so RGB, and that's for color mapping. Then you have a red edge and a near infrared, and that allows you to get more plant-specific light bands. And that way you can do your plant indices like NDVI or NDRE or any number of dozens of plant indices that are out there. If you look around the sensor, it's actually fairly deep, and that's a higher resolution sensor compared to the Red Edge and some of the other multispectral sensors out there, about 3 times the resolution previously. And then also there is a thermal camera, so it's a lower resolution thermal on top of it. So you're getting 6 different layers, all triggered all at once and then all lined on top of each other without using ground control points. And that's a major problem that can happen when you're out in the field. Okay, so that's the sensor. There's some other ports and plugs in here, so I'm assuming, yep, they're in here as well. So there's some of the cables, we'll get to that. There's also a USB storage, and that's a big difference actually between the Altum and the previous Red Edge, is that if we dig in here, yeah, here it is. There is a 120 gigabyte storage device, and you can just plug this in, and that way you're not necessarily using your SD card, which can be a slower write speed. You can write it directly to an external storage, and 128 gigs is a lot of information, but there's a lot of information coming off the 6 bands in the sensor. Okay, we're gonna go and put the lens cap back on. Let's look at the rest of what is in here. If we can put this back in here. Okay, so we have the DLS, or the downwelling light sensor. So there is a plug here that you can plug it directly into the sensor. And we also have the GPS directly in the unit. So there's no external GPS like before. We have some bolts. This is for the mounting brackets, like on an M100. We have a little compass in here, which I'm assuming is for some sort of calibration, maybe a compass calibration when you first start out. Okay, we have a hose cable. So this cable actually plugs directly in. It's a 14-pin cable, and it plugs directly in for communicating to the sensor. It also has a split out so that you can get the power directly out. We have our cable. This longer cable is what you would use to connect the sensor to the Altum to your light sensor. We have a little backup cable here for power if you need it. And then our USB that I just took off. So that's really the unboxing here. And the last thing is really to put it on the M200, which we also got. We can max out the credit card here at Scholar Farms for the holidays. But that's just a quick unboxing of the Altum. And with that, I'm Greg with Scholar Farms, and we'll talk to you again soon.